Well, good morning and welcome to your Suday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel
from
Valley View Farms. Of course, we're in the month of March. Time to think of shamrocks. We have those there to celebrate and everything else.
There you go.
But it's also, you know, we talk a lot about our bird friends, and we've done segments before on feeding the birds during the winter and everything else. And some bird feeders are rather utilitarian, especially the ones that are set up to guard against squirrels.
Exactly.
So that only the birds get the food. But sometimes bird feeders and bird houses, too, can decorate the garden.
That's right, and there's nothing wrong with adding a little bit of whimsy to the garden. Mm-hmm. My favorites this year have been these. All of us have become real bird fans in more than one way. So as we get, you know, as we're headed back up north here pretty soon and watch the Orioles play, here's a nice little way to celebrate.
That's right.
A nice little Ravens planter here, too.
But it's got the suet feeder on the side, on both sides, plus room for the food, and it can carry all kinds because it's got a nice large opening there.
Right, and then others are a little more artsy. Mm-hmm. This one's really nice. I think it kind of fits in with...
It's ceramic.
Yeah, it's ceramic, but it's really cool. It fits in with the tree decor, I want to say, with nature outside.
Right, just make sure a squirrel doesn't knock it down or something like that because it won't survive the trip. And this one, made of wood, beautiful glass walls on it.
And some nice etchings, I guess. So when you fill that up, that's nice.
And this one looks a little more utilitarian, yet not the standard variety.
Just, a little gumball feeder. So it's just something that kids might get into a little bit more when they're out feeding the birds.
Absolutely. And then, you know, I mentioned briefly a bird house. That's something to start thinking about as we go into spring, too. I mean, there's all kinds of these things out there, all kinds of decorations.
It's great. It's a fun art project, too. Yeah. You can paint them. I mean, if you want them to go with your house, you know, you could paint them the same color as your siding and things like that and have some fun with
it. And do a little research because the size of the hole favors the type of bird. Or
exactly.
If the wrong bird gets in with the wrong hole, then somebody else can get in there and get the eggs or something like that. That's all very important. Then, of course, there's the seed.
The seed, and with the seed, you want to, you know, depending on where you have it, if you have a deck or something, you want to look for something that is relatively holeless or high protein. You're not going to end up with a lot of sunflower seed shell down on the ground.
Junk on the ground.
Exactly.
Right,
so take a look at some of those.
It's a little more expensive to get that extra step of processing there. But
it keeps things a lot neater. That's right.
Absolutely.
And just look, you know, different birds like different seed. The finch goes for the real tiny seeds, a lot of the millets and things like that, or thistle type seeds, nuts and stuff for the woodpeckers and chickadees. So, you know, determine what kind of birds you want to attract. And between having the right feeder and the right food, you can really have some fun.
And these seeds are not the kinds you would feed your parakeet or your canary or something. Each bird really has a different preference there.
Exactly. Yeah. And you can find all that out. The bird seed companies have become really good about really identifying the right seed for the right bird.
And I absolutely like the stuff that doesn't leave any trash behind.
I know what you mean.
It really saves a lot of cleanup time. So, feed the birds, but do it in a whimsical way.
That's right. Have some fun with it.
And it helps to decorate the garden. And, you know, think of some shamrocks, too, because it's that time of year. And speaking of the garden, what should we be doing now? We're, going to wind up March here shortly. And the soil's going to be nice to start to work in.
Right. Certainly onion sets can go out now, the white, yellow, the red onion sets, things like shallots, garlic sets can go out, asparagus, horseradish. I mean, you can really get going now. Even some peas can start going out now.
You know, it's time to get excited about this whole thing. We'll be talking about your lawn, your garden, and everything else in the weeks coming up on your Suday Gardener to get you all set for a beautiful garden this summer.
There
Carrie, thanks for joining
Thank
us this
you.
Morning. Next Suday, we'll be back with more.
And if you have a garden question, send it to Suday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go onto our website, WBALTV.com.
Keep feeling like it's never going to get